body organ. Curcumin, quercetin, DHA type oil from the omega-3 oils. Vitamin D3 in particular, very, very potent in reducing that cytokine storm and reducing excess immune overreaction. The best protection you have is a high intake of vitamin D3, and that includes babies, children, women, old people. Everybody will be protected. Now, it takes a high dose. All children, even small children, 2,000 units of vitamin D3 is highly protected. In adults, 5,000 to 10,000 units a day. This is perfectly safe. And what they've shown is that when you do this, not only does it modulate the immune reaction so it doesn't overreact, it also makes your body produce what's called antimicrobial peptides, which are directly will kill viruses, bacteria, and fungi. And we know that the mortality of flu and other type viruses is directly proportional to your vitamin D3 level. So that's the greatest protection you could do, is just start right now on your vitamin D3. That, you know, children should take 2,000, adults at least 5,000 international units a day under the guidance of their physician. And if they do that, their protection and risk of dying will be dramatically less.
You know,
that was my next question, that in Europe here and in England, I've only seen vitamin D sold in up to 200 or 400 international units. And then you look at the instructions for the dosage, and it just says take one per day or something like that. But you're saying that this is not nearly enough to be effective for what it can do. Is that right?
That's right. That's right.
Tell you what, if you're out in the sun, and let's assume you're in your bikini or in your swim and your bathing pants, and you expose your body only for 10 to 15 minutes to the sun, only, okay, your body makes 10,000 to 20,000 units of vitamin D. Sounds a lot, but that's what your body makes naturally. So you can get vitamin D free without paying anything if you really walk into the sun. And I told you, 15 to 20 minutes only, but full body exposure, not just your face, you know, not just your hands or any of it. You know, your full body. And then you can have all you need in the summertime. So the infrared part, you know, these little lamps that you can put on, you know, when you have a cold or something, with the infrared light, it puts heat out, and that's very important also for the formation of the vitamin D.
You got to know one thing here. In the ultraviolet light, we have three different forms. The UVC light ray, we have the UVB light ray, and we have the UVA.
So now what's going to happen? They have a little bit different wavelength, and so they penetrate our body in a different way. And now we have something. What is really dangerous for your skin, what makes your skin wrinkle and old, is the UVA. It's a very aggressive kind of ray. It goes deep into your skin. It changes something on your cells under your skin, the melanocytes, and that is harmful. That we want to block out, okay? If we can.
B is beneficial, and we're going into that. See, the UVB is beneficial because that helps to convert something that comes from a cholesterol that's sitting in your skin into the precursor for the vitamin D3 that you really need.
All. We're also told, if we don't use sunblockers, you know, we're going to get skin cancer. It's all that thing. There are wonderful scientists out there in America that show by scientific proof that you rather get melanomas when you're not out in the sun. Why is that? If you don't go out into the sun, your body is not making vitamin D. And when you have D3 in your body, working in it, it is going against cancer. It's going against skin cancer. Now, when you look at toxicity, there are people around that their only duty is to tell everybody, food is poison, this is poison, that is poison, you can get toxic from it, you can die from it. Okay, and here I did something. For 40,000 units of vitamin D can kill a rat, okay? 40,000 units, and you have to really find that anywhere. But then, equivalently, for a human being that's 75 kilos big, you need 7 million units, and it's nowhere. I mean, you would have to eat so much to kill yourself. It's almost a raid. Don't be afraid of taking normal doses. There is no threat. If you're even taking up to 30,000 units, 10 to 30,000 units, there is no threat for you.
Okay,
so please tell everybody that's pregnant. They have to take up to 6,000 units per day.
We're going
to put sunblockers on us. And the funny thing is, there are also studies. The moment the industry put sunblockers out, and the sunblockers changed chemically, not only that there's poison in the sunblockers, you know, but it blocks out, as I said before, the wrong rays. The beneficial ones they block off, and the aggressive ones they let through. There are very many different kind of sunblockers, and it really shows that the melanoma rate rose exactly with the millions that the industry earned with these sunblockers, selling them to people. Albert, calcemic, you know, you don't get too much calcium in your body when you do 10,000 units per day, but the safe lower limit is 2,000 units per day. Okay, but that, when your levels are low, it's not enough. What I would suggest, go on to 5,000 units per day and take that 5 months, because it takes a long time till you can raise your blood. You know, when you're at a level where you can prevent that, it will take you only 2,000 units per day to keep it up. And that doesn't cost much.
Remind you to really start now.
Getting your levels up prevents a lot. Really start now. Start now while you still can get this, while you still can get these dosages of vitamin D. You can get it 2,000 units in a bottle and in one pill. You can get it 5,000 units. You can get it in America, but also there are sources
here. High
dose. And as I said, it's getting stored. And then slowly the body takes out of what it needs till in 3 months it runs down. And I said the doses was 100,000 units. That's a lot. And they showed no signs of toxicity.
Okay.
That's a proven fact by some scientists.
Sorry. And let me risk a summary and run it past you about
ahead.
What I think I've learned here.
Yeah.
Is that we're all likely to be deficient in vitamin D3.
Right.
If we're concerned, especially as we're heading into a period of lower sunlight and the fact that we're in Europe and not living on the equator,
yeah.
Therefore we should be supplementing ourselves. And if we're
right.
Supplementing ourselves, we should be supplementing ourselves at least 5,000 units.
One thing, the bigger your fatty tissue is, the more the vitamin D gets stuck in the fat. And the people, the bigger they are, they have very little serum levels of vitamin D, because it gets stuck in the fat and it doesn't go out in the blood.